bards shall be marked for generosity and affection, and for encouraging competitors, they shall be cosmos, without monopoly or secrecy, glad to pass anything to anyone, hungry for equals night and day, they shall not be careful of riches and privilege.
Don't you think I rate a hello?
Who goes there, hankering, gross, mystical, mute? I didn't catch your name. I did not ask who you are. The blackboard and teacher's diagrams. That is not important to me.
You know, you all know exactly who I am.
What is a man anyhow? What am I? And what are you?
Say my name.
Woodrow Wilson.
Say my name.
Willy Wonka.
Say my name.
Walter White.
You're goddamn right.
Singer and traveller, the anatomist, chemist.
The study of change. Solution, dissolution, growth and decay, then transformation.
All with substance and increase. Astronomer, geologist, phrenologist, spiritualist, mathematician, historian and lexicographer are not poets, but they are the lawgivers of poets, and their construction underlines the structure of every perfect poem.
I simply respect chemistry. Chemistry must be respected.
The distillation would intoxicate me also, but I shall not let it. The distillation is odorless.
I know the chemistry.
Hurrah for positive science. Arrests of criminals. Slights. Adulterous offers made. Acceptances. Rejections with convex lips. I mind them or the resonance of them.
I am not a criminal. No offence to people who are.
One of the centripetal and centrifugal gang where cattle stand and shake away flies.
We are not making anything, but we catch this fly.
With the tremulous shuddering of their hides, where the cheesecloth hangs in the kitchen, and andirons straddle the hearth slab, and cobwebs fall in festoons from the rafters.
Is there a discernible point to this story? A point that you'll be arriving at in the near future?
Expression of speech is in what is written or said. Forget not that silence is also expressive, that anguish as hot as the hottest and contempt as cold as the coldest may be without words, that the true adoration is likewise without words and without kneeling.
Betty forgets the aluminum. Guaranteed. Betty. Oh, hang on, there seems to be some kind of disparity between our line lengths, you know. You get like 30 words and you follow my instructions.
You light surfaces only. I force the surfaces and the depths also.
Now you listen to me.
The sound of the belch words of my voice. Words loosed to the eddies of the wind.
Am I the only person capable of behaving in a professional manner?
I too am untranslatable. I sound my barbaric yawp over the room. We're done here.
We're done, and I say we're done.
The whole thing. Oh.
The whole thing. All of it. It's all about me.
And what I assume, you should assume. For every atom belonging to me, as good as belongs to you.
We'll just have to agree to disagree. What I do need is your full attention. Listen and apply yourself.
Have you reckoned the earth much?
Some kind of tough dispute apparently we lost.
I become any presence or truth of humanity here, and see myself in prison, shaped like another man, and feel the dull, unintermittent pain.
I'm comforting. I'm a comforting presence.
Meanwhile, corpses lie in new-made graves, bloody corpses of young men.
Chemical disincorporation. cooperation. Is this going to be a regular thing now, meth cooking and corpse disposal?
And as to you, corpse, I think you are good manure, but that does not offend me. I smell the white roses, sweet-scented and growing. I reach to the leafy lips. What is known, I strip away. I launch all men and women forward with me into the unknown. It is time to explain myself. Let us stand up.
I don't want to talk about it. I'm done explaining to you or anyone else.
My words are words of a questioning and to indicate reality. My words itch at your ears till you understand them.
I truly believe there exists some combination of words. There must exist certain words in a certain specific order that would explain all of this.
While I loaf and invite my soul, I lean and loaf at my ease, observing a spear of summer grass.
You should see his house. He has actual hobos living there.
To a drudge of the cotton fields, or emptier of privies, I lean. On his right cheek, I put the family kiss.
I was and am providing for my family.
Patriarchs sit at supper with sons and grandsons and great-grandsons around them, in walls of adobe, in canvas tents.
No one looks twice at a tented house.
Rest hunters and trappers after their day's sport. The city sleeps and the country sleeps. The living sleep for their time, the dead sleep for their time.
There's no better reason than family.
I bequeath myself to the dirt to grow from the grass I love. If you want me again, look for me under your boot soles.
Cheer up, beautiful people.
The infected in the immigrant hospital are not nothing. The murderer or mean person is not nothing. The perpetual succession of shadow people are not nothing as they go. The prostitute is not nothing. The mocker of religion is not nothing as he goes.
They're not coming back. Not after tonight.
Only the lull I like. The hum of your velvet voice.
When I heard the learned astronomer and from time to time looked up in silence at the stars. It's a poem by Walt Whitman, UWW.
Walt Whitman, an American, one of the roughs,
you
a
got
cosmos.